introduce yourself.
So our first question would be, why is the fight against trafficking important?
Trafficking is very important agenda for underdeveloped state like Bihar. If you consider India to be south in contrast with north, that means south is an underdeveloped country, north is a developed country. So if India is south of north, then Bihar is south of south.
Okay.
Yeah. So it is an underdeveloped state within the underdeveloped country. Now here the traffic is very important. Usually from an underdeveloped state, the girl trafficking takes place. Because of compulsions, parents, sometimes they sell their children, sometimes because of lack of security, they are kidnapped. So it is part of atrocities which is inflicted on girl child or adolescent girl. So it is some sort of a gender discrimination that we see provincially, nationally, or sometimes globally.
So what do you think about the approach of APNI App against trafficking?
APNI App is some sort of a organic institution which has generated from the grassroots level. Is not an imposed organization, and they are working on this agenda consistently for several years. The most important thing of APNI App is that they are not only functioning at a grassroots level, they are also functioning at academic level. So they are doing several types of advocacy nationally, globally. They have been able to prompt several academic, intellectual people who are working on the gender issues on theory as well as practice, and link them with this organization. So whatever they are doing, the grassroots level, the consciousness of that is not only being felt nationally but even globally. In that sense, it's a very unique organization. Many of the organizations, their reach is limited, their cognitive world is also limited, they are unable to think at a global level. So this is a unique organization which is connecting the agenda locally but also disseminating it globally.
Yes, that also brings us to the next question, is how is it connected to the women's movement and the social justice movement in Bihar?
Yeah, I mean, for example, APNI App has also played an important role in creating gender-centric consciousness with the present government here. I think Bihar is part of the Hindi heartland. So this is one of the most deprived states even within Hindi heartland, within India. But in terms of gender sensitivity or gender equality, the level of deprivation is relatively less because of organization like APNI App, which has been able to do advocacy in a very consistent manner, and in this way several agenda which government has taken. For example, you know, Panchayati Raj institutions, that is the fourth tier of governance, there is a 50% reservations for women. This is, Bihar is possibly the only state in the country where these are 35 reservations, that is positive discrimination for women in the government job. This is a very important agenda. Bihar is one of the very few states where bicycle was given to the woman, school level girls to go to school in a bicycle. Bicycle was in some what symbol of liberty, symbol of independence. So even though Bihar has been backward, even though there are many ills in Bihar, it is relatively more gender sensitive, and it has been able to do many things to the government because of the consistent advocacy of Apni Aap for the last several years.
So the next question is, when did you meet Rupshi Rajita, and what do you think about her leadership on this field?
I don't remember when I met her. I mean, it seems now I know her since ages. We have been interacting for a long period, so I cannot give you exactly time frame, but I know her for ages. And when I first met him, I think since then we have been able to develop a very close relationship. He has been a guiding spirit. He is from Bihar, and so even though she is involved at a grassroots level, she is herself a top international academics, especially on gender studies. She is a professor in USA. So there are very few people who operate at an international level, but sometimes lose their local connections. She is one of the very few people who has international connection along with local connection. And because of her, I think Forbes Ganj, where Apne Aap is located, is even backward even within Bihar. So many people could go there because of her. And she has been able to bring Forbes Ganj and the atrocities of the woman or agenda of trafficking at a national level, at a provincial level, at a global level. This could be choreographed by Ruchira in a beautiful manner. She has been doing it for a long time. She brings out, she edits a very high quality magazine. So she operates at various levels, operates at advocacy level, operates at policy level and various other.
So that's our last question now. Do you have any suggestions for the future work of Apne Aap?
Can you repeat the question?
If you have a suggestion you would like to make for the work, future work of Apne Aap?
No, I don't have any suggestion as such. Possibly they can expand their base more in Bihar. Mm-hmm. And they should also have a large presence in Patna, which is the state capital. And whatever they are doing at Forbes Ganj, that is important. Their presence in Patna further bring the agenda provincial level in a very decisive manner. That should be done. So I think that is the only suggestion. That's the agenda, as far as commitment, as far as complete devotion to the topic, is absolutely marvelous. And in some sense, it's a popular topic for other organizations to emulate, become some sort of example for other people to emulate.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.
Your tea will get cold.